This hedgehog will not be losing to anyone here. And it was possible due to the Wan2.1 Fusion X GGUF model. The video is for users with 8 GB of VRAM in their computer. And this is the simple workflow we will be looking at. Well, there are 3 workflows. The first is for the text-to-video generation. The second is for image-to-video generation. And third is for upscaling the generated video. Why upscaling, you may ask? In the older video, I showed the Fusion X model, not the GGUF model, but the larger model, which occupied almost the entire 16 GB of VRAM. It was not practical for many users. Let's look at something more focused on smaller graphic cards by maintaining the video quality. So, inside the comfyUI manager, if we look at the installed nodes, I have only one, that is the manager itself. In the missing nodes, these 2 custom nodes will be needed to run the workflow. These are both the most common nodes. You may have this already. I will install the nightly version of these nodes, then restart and reload the comfyUI. You can download the files from here. I will not do it right now. Instead, I will get it from Hugging Face, which should give you a clear understanding of it. These are the 3 nodes that require certain files. I will start with the UNet model, uploaded by QuantStack. This is a text-to-video 14 billion GGUF model. Starting from Q2, these are the quantized models. In this demo, I will be using this Q3 model, as this should work for most of the users and can produce decent results. I also tried the Q2 version. It has prompt adherence, but the video quality is too low. Download the model, save it inside the comfyUI's models, and then the UNet folder. Next will be the clip loader. And these are the files needed by the clip loader node. So, based on the UNet I downloaded, I will have the Q3KM file. I do not see the encoder for the respective Q2 UNet file. So, you can have the smallest Q3 encoder if you are using the Q2 UNet file. Download the file and save it inside the models folder, and then inside the text encoder folder. Next, we need the VAE. There are 2 options for VAE. This BF16 file is one of those 2. The other is this uploaded by comfyUI. Links for these files will be shared in the description. I will download this file and save it inside the VAE folder. I will press the letter R to refresh the list of files in this interface. And then I will select the files in all 3 nodes. So, in this workflow, I do not think any explanation is needed. All goes to K-sampler, and the output is then converted from latent space to pixel space. Further, it is used to make a video. I duplicated these 2 nodes because one is for generating landscape video, and the other is for portrait like a mobile phone. The prompt here is from the internet and black box AI. There are a few settings in this video that you should be looking at, like this frame rate, which is 16 right now. If I keep the length to 80 frames, one extra is added by the comfyUI interface. So 16 frames a second will generate a 5-second video with a length of 80 frames. You can generate 10-second videos by keeping 160 seconds. Just remember comfyUI will add 1 frame on top, so it will be 161 frames. The file name prefix is up to you. Make sure you have a proper video format selected here. I have selected H.264. I will click Run to queue the workflow, and the loading will take a few seconds, which will happen on the first run. It takes around 13 seconds for a step, and the video will be generated in 10 steps. You can try increasing the steps by a few numbers further. I started getting bad results after 17 steps. After 196 seconds, which is around 3 minutes, I got the result, and it looks good. What do you think? It looks good to me. The video generated is a low 480 by 272 pixel video. So I will be upscaling this video. This is a simple workflow for upscaling an image. Upscaling takes some serious hardware. So, this is a very basic upscaler that does the work. This node takes the upscaling model, and this node here controls the number of frames to be processed at a time. This is the upscale node. And this is where all the upscaled images will be combined to form a video. The frames specified here are the images. This node is where I will be uploading the video, and this node will be sending the video details to the video combine node. The detail that needs to be present here is the frame rate of the uploaded video. It must match the video combine node. Not doing so gave me an error. The load upscale node needs a model. I got a few upscalers from this website. I will be sharing the link in the description. I can download the PTH file from here. Save the file inside the models and then in the upscale model folder. There are many upscalers for different types of videos. The category has been listed here. This is for anime scenes. You can get the PTH files. You can apply a filter on Civit AI for upscalers, but there are limited options. I will download this upscaler. Save it inside the upscale model. In the workflow, I will first try the one I downloaded from OpenModelDB. I will upload the video from the output folder of comfyUI. And this node controls the number of frames to be processed at a time. A batch of 16 will make 5 batches because the video I have uploaded has 80 frames. This makes upscaling possible even on longer videos. I will click Run to queue the workflow. It takes around 14 seconds to process one batch, and I got the result quickly. The upscale video is not that great, but it is better than the low-resolution video I had before. There is an increase in file size, and the video is now a 1080p video. I will try the other upscaler I downloaded from Civit AI, and this time I will process one frame at a time. Run the workflow. In the output, you will see all the batches being processed. There will be 81 batches, which is as per the frames in the video. I think this upscaler gave a better result. I did the text to the video generation. Let's look at the image to video generation. The workflow is simple. There are a few extra nodes because I will be bringing an image for reference to generate a video. These are the 4 nodes expecting some files to generate an image. I will get the UNet from Hugging Face. And these are the quantized image to video models. I will be starting with the Q3 model for the demo. Save it inside the models and then the UNet folder. Next is the clip loader. And I have already downloaded the encoder corresponding to the Q3 model when I was generating text to video. A clip vision file will be needed because I will be introducing an image in the workflow. The clip vision can be downloaded from here, uploaded by comfyUI, download the file and save it inside the clip vision folder. The last is the VAE, and I had already downloaded it when I was running the text to video workflow. This is where I downloaded the VAE from, and you also have another BF16 VAE, which I have not tried yet. I generated an image from the Flux model, and the prompt says, "Winds are blowing, a girl runs towards the beach. Train departs, and a puppy follows the character from behind." I tried running the workflow, but I got an error. I spoke about these files, but forgot to select them in the node. Press the letter R to refresh and select the files. After I ran the workflow, I got this result. After spending a good amount of time, I saw that the model selected was a text-to-video model. I selected the correct image-to-video model and queued the workflow to process. The generation time for a step has been increased from 13 seconds to 27 seconds. And because I am using the GGUF models, the system's memory is below 50%. I got the result in 300 seconds, and I got what I asked for. I think my prompt should have been bigger. I tried again and got the result in 309 seconds. The puppy came too suddenly. I will try upscaling the anime. The batch was set as 1. You can keep the batch at 16 frames. This upscaler is simple and uses less VRAM. I got the upscaled version and the video looks sharper. I should not be using a realistic model on anime images. I downloaded this anime Sharp V4 model and it was a saved insert file. The upscaled video looks better to me. The sharp lines are not there in this result. I'm not saying this is perfect, but I think this is the best on an 8GB card. I will add one more thing. Make sure to edit the prompt even after getting it from GPT. Make it in such a way that it goes along with the image. I hope you got the workflow and the upscaling part. I tried testing further text-to-video generation with a Q3 model, and the results were great. I asked for a prompt for downhill bicycling from ChatGPT. This prompt I asked was just an old memory of Downhill Domination, a video game on PlayStation 2, which I played years ago. After every generation, I modified the prompt to get close to what I wanted. The upscale model Remacry from Civit AI works well in most cases. It won't work on anime and cartoons. You have to look for models for anime. This little guy was fearless and went all out with a Q6 image to video model. This cute blob here was trying to say he saw something furious in the jungle. It was a squirrel with a fired-up sword, slicing everyone in its path. The image here is of size 1024 pixels. I tried decreasing the resolution of an image to 512 pixels so it would be easy for my computer to read and process this image. My video resolution was even lower than the resized image because I'm using the Q8 480p model. Make sure to match the aspect ratio of the image. The result generated looks good. The Q8 model generates a superior quality video in comparison to the Q3 model. This 5-second video was generated on a Q8 model. I tried 160 frames for a 10-second video, but it gave an out-of-memory error. And this 10-second video was generated using Q3 model. The video looks a bit dark. The edges look unclear. The 10-second video took around 500 seconds to generate. Above is the out-of-memory error. I tried upscaling the 10-second video generated by the Q3 model. The upscale model used was Remacry. The result I received was a sharp video with outlines sometimes being duplicated. I downloaded a different upscale model from Civit AI, and this is the result. The Q3 model should definitely work on 8GB, and after upscaling it does come near to the Q8 model. What do you think? I think this is better than other models available open source on an 8GB graphic card.